Hey guys, welcome to How to Draw Happy Tree Friends. I am Kenn Navarro.
And I am Warren Graff.
Alright, so today we will be drawing Cuddles.
Cuddles. Seriously.
For reals, yeah. This time for reals, not practice. So, I like to start, and you're supposed to start with the body, and we should probably do that. So their body's kind of like an oblong that's kind of pear-shaped, sort of bigger at the bottom than it is at the top. So there's this body, and then their head is just this big round thing. And I'm just lightly sketching it out right now, you know, to just kind of place it in. Maybe it's a little too big. Let's start over.
You start over.
There we go. See? Eraser. Erases everything. All the mistakes. Even murder. There you go. That's a little better. More proportional. Give us a little more room up there for his ears. So now we have sort of his basic shape. And for Cuddles, usually I like to start with his head poof, which is right around here. I'm just going to kind of draw a circle to indicate where that is, and then he's got this kind of cloudy-esque looking poof for hair at the top of his head, right in the middle. It's kind of lumpy space princess-ish.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Go. And then I actually like to start drawing his ears now too as well. And they're just these big kind of floppy ears. And I'm just kind of sketching it out right now. And then I'll go back in with a darker line to just kind of really define that shape. And then he has like an inner ear shape. It's basically kind of like the smaller shape of that. There you go. And then kind of just fill in the rest of his head. Or the shape of it, rather. It's not a perfect circle, but... or oblongy shape, but it's okay. It's okay. Don't have to be perfect. So there you go. So normally, when I kind of sketch this out, depending on, you know, where he's facing, I would do sort of like a... you know, like if he's facing left, I'd sort of draw a dotted line or, you know, guidelines to know so that I know where the center is, so that the shape, I can keep sort of the round shape as part of the drawing. Otherwise, it might look, you know, kind of flat. Right. So, and we're just going to draw Cuddles like kind of facing forward. So I'm just going to lightly sketch in sort of a... you know, sort of the center lines for both horizontal and vertical.
Right.
So I'll know, and usually right kind of right here at the center is where I put the nose. And they have the cutest little heart-shaped noses. Yes, you do.
Just like real life.
Yeah. And I talk to my drawings just like in real life, too. Yes, you do. Who's gonna nose? So once the nose is there, that sort of helps you guide to put where the rest of the face is. Usually right around here is where I'll put their eyes, and they have these big old oblong eyes. And they actually started smaller, but as the years went by, we've sort of made their designs bigger and bigger. It just makes them look really more, you know, more and more cuter.
They're all about being cute.
Mm-hmm. Makes the death, oh, so much more satisfying. So, there are their eyes. And I'll just draw on their pupils, and I'll just have them kind of looking up at Warren.
Aw. He likes
wondering,
me.
Like, hey. And they have, so I'm just drawing, like, these oblongs again to help guide me where that is. And then they have these Pac-Man eyes, so when I come back in, I'll just ink that and then sort of just shade it all in. Ta-da! We're almost there. Very recognizable now.
It's lumpy.
Exactly. How could you tell? So the other biggest feature that they have are their mouths. Very expressive that way. Big mouths and big eyes. So I like to give them these big smiles. And of course, their patented buck teeth. But you see how everything's kind of lining up in the center. You know, all these features sort of, you can use that as a guide to place all these things. And I like to give them a little kind of indication of a tongue, just to give that mouth a little bit of a dimension. So it just doesn't look as, you know, flat, just a little bit more interesting. And then we can shade that in too. Sometimes even, you know, when they're screaming, I'll draw their...
A wiggly tongue.
Yeah, their uvula. Just as a cartoon. Ta-da! There we go. Let's not forget his cheeks. He has, like, little round cheeks.
Nice.
So, for the rest of his body, we'll go back down here. They don't have, these guys don't really have necks. So their arms just sort of jut out from where their head meets their body. And they just have these little stubby arms that actually, if you, draw, well, it's a little shorter than the other one. That's why this is so important.
See, even professionals erase.
So if you, I was saying, like, if you sort of project where their arms are, it'll never reach the top of their, or even the side of their heads.
It can never scratch his ears.
Yeah, so it can never scratch their, so what we do is we sort of just cheat and, like, you know, if he has to scratch his ears or something, or, you know, we'll just have a hand kind of popping up at the back there. It's cheating.
Wait, you do cuddle.
Cheating is good, kids.
When it comes to drawing.
So there's his arms. And then we'll fill in the rest of his body. Sort of comes down again. It's sort of smaller at the top and kind of bigger at the bottom, give him that kind of pudgier shape. And right where this kind of curves in is where I usually start the feet. And they have these, you know, really stumpy legs. And you can kind of imagine cylinders, just these little cylinders down here. And just little feet. And Cuddles has, of course, little bunny slippers. So don't forget to draw that. And they have the little ears. Is that weird?
No.
Would you wear human slippers? Human-shaped slippers?
How do you know I don't?
I guess it's not weird then. Kind of cannibalistic, I guess.
They have bunny tails on the back of them, don't they? The slippers?
Oh, snap. It's underneath. No,
oh, yeah. That's right. That's right.
Not so there we are. Circle. And then we just draw his... they also have a tummy. Tummy shape. Sort of indicates their tummy. And there you go. Cuddles in all his glory. And you can just go back in with that eraser or with a smaller, finer eraser and sort of get rid of some of the sketch lines, just make it a little bit cleaner. Get rid of those guidelines that we used earlier as much as you can. Ta-da!
Yay!
Cuddles!
Good job!
Thanks!
Alright, I'm proud of you!
You'd be awful if I can't do that after all these years,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, exactly. Should be able to do that blindfolded.
I am blindfolded.
I mean, yes.
I'm legally blind, by the way.
Folded.
This is all, I'm doing this all.
You're legally blindfolded.
Exactly. So, thanks for joining us, and catch you guys again next time.
Later.